Okay, Andy, now we're going to talk about the gubernatorial race. Obviously, Mitch Daniels is heading to Purdue University. His record, he certainly, whether some people might have their own feelings about what he accomplished, he certainly did have a productive tenure. But right now we'll have, obviously, Mike Pence, the U.S. House number three, and obviously John Gregg, Democratic opponent. What are you seeing in this race? I had seen that Pence might have a comfortable lead. What are you seeing?
Well, he does. Every poll that's come out shows Pence with at least a double-digit lead, sometimes into the low teens. So, you know, that's pretty comfortable. So we expect that to close a little bit because Gregg's a reasonably funded campaign. He's got a decent amount of money. He'll be able to do some things with that money. So that gap should narrow. But when you start with a 10, 11, 12, 13-point lead, you can let it narrow quite a bit and still win. The question is, in the last 3 weeks, can Gregg get enough momentum to close that gap even faster? And there are a lot of people who are suspecting that at its current trajectory, that would not happen by Election Day. It would take additional time. And Pence really hasn't been on the defensive yet. He's continued to focus on the things he wants to talk about and basically never make reference to his opponents. So there's still time for that to be done, which could take some of the shine off of John Gregg if there is a shine there. So, you know, it does look like a race that's comfortable. But I can't help but notice that in the debate, the most recent debate, the second debate, John Gregg had a pretty good performance, not a great performance. Mike Pence had certainly an adequate, at worst, performance. But he did seem a little flatter and almost seemed a little more on the defensive. Which leads me to believe that it's true we're seeing that normal narrowing that we would expect, but he was not so nervous about it that leads me to believe that it's really narrowed fast.
Is there anything that you think that John Gregg should be talking about that maybe he is not? Obviously, Mike Pence's record is fairly clear. I mean, he's obviously been in his voting record has to be clear. Is there something that you think Gregg could do to speed it up?
You know, when you run a campaign, you do have to introduce yourself. If you start out right away being negative, that puts a bad taste in people's mouth. And John Gregg did not have great name recognition when he started this race. Really, he should have started doing a lot of stuff a lot earlier than he did. And this is a common criticism from people about his campaign. The Gregg campaign started out with those folksy, I'm John Gregg commercials, the guy with two first names. And as one person said to me, if John Gregg could go meet every voter, he'd probably win, because he's a nice guy, he's an affable guy, he's a moderate, he certainly is not a far lefty, so a lot of Republicans should be comfortable with him. Unfortunately, those ads also didn't exactly appeal to people in the northwestern part of the state, where they're looking for something a little less down home, and it didn't really appeal to people in Indianapolis either. Although folks know him there, they know he's kind of folksy, it didn't work the way it worked in the southern part of the state. Now, if you've looked most recently, his ads have taken a different approach. They're not quite as folksy. You know, there's the one with him standing in what looks like the Capitol building, and he's getting a little more aggressive in his attacks on Mike Pence. The debate, he got a little feisty, not quite what we saw in a vice presidential debate, but still a little feisty. So he needs to keep doing more of that. Mike Pence has been great about talking about economic issues. He knows that's the number one issue in the state. So everything is about economic issues. In fact, when he talked about his family impact statement, which by most people's standards would probably fall under the category of a social issue, he described it as an economic issue, which was great. That's what he needed to do. It was the right thing to do. And in the second debate, you heard John Gregg say, that's not an economic issue, that's a social issue. This guy's a social conservative and he should be scaring a lot of you. That's some of what Gregg has to do, but if he goes too far, it'll turn voters off.